Hey guys, YouTuber 100 here. Alright, now continuing my horror movie reviews. Now I'm gonna review for you guys Nightmare on Elm Street 3, Dream Warriors. Alright, yeah, so, yeah, as you all know, I reviewed the first movie a couple of weeks ago, so if you haven't seen it, go check it out, yeah. And, yeah, the reason I'm just skipping right to the third movie and just is going over the second movie, yeah, just going. Just skipping the second movie, yeah, is because, yeah, there's nothing really from the second movie at all that continues the storyline from the first movie, so yeah, this is the movie that continues the storyline from the first movie, because Nancy returns here, and this just is the movie that continues the storyline from the first movie, and not the second one. Yeah, the second one just has a complete new storyline that doesn't carry over to any of the other movies, so yeah. That's the reason why I'm just skipping right to this and jumping past the second one. Alright. So yeah, I thought this was a pretty good movie. Probably, like, the second best Elm Street movie, yeah. Yeah, thought this was a pretty good movie. I give this about 3.5 stars out of 4, yeah. Yeah, and like I said, Nancy returns in this movie, and so does her father, although her father isn't really in this. He doesn't come along until, like, the last 45 minutes of the movie, maybe. Yeah. So. Oh, yeah. So let me just get right into the review. Alright, so the movie starts with, like, this girl, Kristen, building, like, a model of Nancy's house with some pieces of newspaper and popsicle sticks. Then her mother comes into her room, it's like after 1 in the morning, and she tells Kristen to go to sleep. And then, and as Kristen is laying in bed, when she sits up in bed, she sees there's Nancy's house, and there's that Freddy Krueger rhyme, 1, 2, Freddy's coming for you. Then she goes in the house, and she sees some little girl there. She's going around looking for her, and then she starts to carry that girl out of the house. And then she sees Freddy is chasing after her, whatever, and she gets, like, stuck in some sticky goo stuff. It's like, right when Freddy's about to get her, she then, like, wakes up. It was a dream. And then she then went to the bathroom, and she was trying to turn on the sink. I think the knobs were Freddy's hands. And, yeah, these hands were holding on to her. Yeah, Kristen starts screaming, and she saw Freddy in the mirror. And then Kristen's mother came in, and then she saw that Kristen kind of, like, had a cut on her arm or something. So she then took Kristen to some kind of mental hospital or something. And she was talking to the doctors, Dr. Gordon and Dr. Sims. Yeah, and then, you know, as they were trying to sedate Kristen or something, Kristen started to freak out, and she was just screaming, and she was just uncontrollable. And Dr. Gordon tried to, like, calm her down by giving her a shot, but Kristen kicked him, and then Kristen just went crazy. And then she started to recite the Freddy Krueger rhyme. Then, when she got to, like, the 9-10 part, Nancy then appeared, and she said, "Had she finished it?" And yeah. And then later, Nancy was talking with Dr. Gordon. Dr. Gordon was asking Nancy how she found out about that rhyme, and she told him. And it's just something people say to keep the boogeyman away. Dr. Gordon was telling Nancy that everyone that was there had dreams about the boogeyman, who was Freddy Krueger. And then as Nancy was leaving, then Dr. Gordon saw a nun. He saw her throughout the movie, yeah. The nun we later found out was Freddy Krueger's mother. And yeah, the nun just kept disappearing out of Dr. Gordon's sight. And back at the hospital, one of the assistant doctors or whatever, Max, was giving Nancy a tour of the place, and she met two of the patients, who were Philip and Kincaid. Yeah, Philip told Nancy that he was a sleepwalker, and Max was telling Nancy about Kincaid that he's in isolation a lot because of his attitude. Yeah, Nancy also saw some things that Kincaid made. Hey, there were like puppets or something made of like paper or something, yeah. And then later on, everyone gathered around, like introducing herself to Nancy. Yeah, there was this guy Will who was in a wheelchair. There, yeah. And then a girl, and also another girl named Jennifer, who said that when she got out of the place that she was gonna be a TV star. And also a guy named Joey who really never really spoke. Also a girl named Taryn who was also a drug addict. Yeah. And Philip was saying that they're all here because of their dreams of the boogeyman or whatever. And then that night, when they went to bed, Will told Joey to stay awake and make sure that nothing was happened, that if there was even one whimper from Will, for Joey to wake him up. And then Nancy and Dr. Gordon and were like just talking some more, and Nancy told Dr. Gordon about her parents, that her mother died in her sleep once because, yeah, remember what happened during the first movie, she was killed by Freddy. And her father really doesn't talk to her anymore, something like that, yeah. And then, in Philip and Kincaid's room, then one of Philip's puppets or whatever became Freddy. Yeah, Freddy was one of the puppets, and then, yeah, it was in Philip's dream. Freddy then cut open Philip's arms and legs, and he was using Philip's veins, like puppet strings or whatever, so he could, like, walk him around as if he were a puppet and make it seem like he was sleepwalking. And it woke up Kincaid, and he saw Philip just sleepwalking, yeah, in the reality world. Yeah, there was, yeah, Philip's veins weren't exposed. Yeah, it just looked like he was sleepwalking. And then Joey could see upstairs where Philip was walking. Yeah, Philip was like at the end of a balcony or something. Yeah, then Joey woke up Will, and he saw that Philip was there, and then Joey went to get help. Went to a nurse or something, yeah, but obviously he didn't speak, and then he grabbed some tray and whacked all the bedroom doors, and everyone went to Joey and Will's room, and they saw Philip on the edge of the balcony, and they were all just screaming at Philip to not do it. But yeah, because Philip was about to fall out of off the balcony or something, yeah, and then back in Philip's dream, we saw his veins back, and then Freddy cut them, and Philip went flying out of off the balcony or whatever, down to the ground, and yeah, obviously he died. Then the next day, the doctors weren't convinced that he was murdered or whatever. They were saying that it was just a sleepwalking accident or suicide, and so they didn't look into it anymore. Yeah. And then the following night, Jennifer was up watching TV, trying to do some research for being a TV star. And then Max told her that he never saw her. And Jennifer started to drift off, and so what she did to keep awake was she lit a cigarette and burned her hand with it. And you could hear the sizzle. And then Jennifer was watching a talk show with Zsa Zsa Gabor. And yeah, it just started off as just a natural interview, but it turned out the host was really Freddy Krueger. And right when he was about to do something to Zsa Zsa Gabor, or the TV like lost signal, and then Jennifer like slowly walked up to the TV, then she gave it a whack, and then robot arms came out of the TV and grabbed Jennifer and lifted her up. And then Freddy's head came up from the top of the TV. And then he said, "This is it, Jennifer. Your big break in TV. Welcome to prime time, bitch." And then Freddy smashed Jennifer right through the TV. And then Max came back in and he saw Jennifer was just in there through the TV. And then we had Jennifer's funeral, where Freddy's mother, who was just a nun, approached Dr. Gordon again. And they started talking, and then Nancy came up, and then Freddy's mother was gone. Then with all the patients that were left, Nancy was telling them about Freddy Krueger and describing them and saying that the reason he's after them is because they're the only kids left on Elm Street and it's because of their parents burning him that he's doing this. And then Dr. Gordon was then and saying was trying to hypnotize them into a sleep or something. Then, yeah. And meanwhile, there was a nurse trying to, like, flirt with Joey or something. Yeah. And then everyone then eventually went into their sleeps, and then they could do whatever they dream of doing or whatever. And Philip could get out of his wheelchair, and he was like a wizard. And Kristen was, like, really flexible. She was able to do a lot of flips, and Philip was, oh, not Philip, sorry, yeah, Kincaid, he was, like, able to be really strong or whatever, and, yeah, Taryn was, like, beautiful and bad. Yeah. And back with Joey and the nurse, the nurse then took off her clothes, and, yeah, we saw her boobs, she was nude, and, yeah, that made Joey weak. And then the nurse was start kissing Joey. Then turns out it was really Freddy. And then Freddy, like, with a tongue, tied Joey's arms and legs to railings of the bed. And, like, the bed moved, and then there was, like, a big inferno thing. Yeah, and then, yeah, things started to get kind of crazy in the dreams with all of them. And then Dr. Sims came in, and then everyone was just asleep, and Joey was out cold on the floor. And then, yeah, he was in a bed, and he was, yeah, he was taken, like, to some other part of the hospital, and he was just in bed. Doctor said he was in a coma. And then, later on, Nancy, he was just sitting beside Joey while he was just out. She knew what happened to him. She knew it was Freddy responsible for it, and she said, "Give him back." And then on Joey's chest, Freddy, like, wrote, "Come and get him, bitch." And then, yeah, Nancy and Dr. Gordon then went over to Nancy's father. Father, yeah. And Nancy was telling him that Freddy was back, and they need to know where his bones were. Yeah, and then, but Nancy's father didn't tell her anything. Yeah, he was just saying that Freddy's dead and he's not around anymore. Yeah, he was just denying Freddy was there. And then, back over at the hospital, Dr. Sims, after Kristen was going crazy, she told Max to have her sedated and put in the in isolation or whatever. And then Taryn called Dr. Gordon and told him what was going on. And Dr. Gordon sent Nancy back over to the hospital as he tried to convince Nancy's father some more. And then Dr. Gordon told Nancy's father they would go on a scavenger hunt. And so, yeah, Nancy's father took Dr. Gordon to, like, a church or something. It's like, and Dr. Gordon filled up a glass bottle with holy water. And then a priest asked what he was doing there. Yeah, Dr. Gordon just, like, left the priest's watch or something. Then when Nancy got back to the hospital, Max told Nancy that Dr. Sims gave him orders to not let anyone see Kristen, especially Nancy. And Nancy wanted to see the other patients, so yeah, they were in the TV room, and then Nancy told them. And yeah, there was Will, Taryn, and Kincaid. She told them that Joey was in the quote-unquote dream world, and Kristen's about to go in, so they would have to go in too. And that this would be really dangerous, and that if they get killed in the dream, they would die in the real world. Yeah. And they all went in, they had their special powers again. They were in the isolated place where Kristen was. And they all split up to go find Joey. Yeah, and then... And, yeah, Dr. Gordon and Nancy's father then arrived at the junkyard where Freddy's bones were, or when Nancy's father killed him. And then they were just digging for his bones. And, yeah. And then, yeah, then Kristen started to have a flashback of what was at the beginning of the movie. With her mother coming in, but yeah, it was changed when Kristen got into bed. Yeah, Freddy then got Kristen's mother and, like, beheaded her or something. Yeah. Then Kristen, like, jumped out of the room or something and out downstairs of Nancy's house. Yeah. And then we cut to Taryn, and then we saw her kind of, like, in a bad place, a bad neighborhood or somewhere. Yeah. There was some graffiti that said Freddy and Taryn or something. It was in a heart. Yeah. And then Taryn then came across Freddy. She was trying to fight him with some blades. Yeah. And then Freddy then had some syringes filled with heroin on his finger or something, and he injected them into Taryn and killed her. Then cut to Will. Freddy had like a fatal wheelchair or something. Yeah, and Will was able to dodge it, and he had his wizard powers, and he was able to get rid of it. Then he tried to make Freddy disappear. He, like, had some stuff go at him or something, and as Will was running towards Freddy, Freddy then grabbed him, and he lifted Will up. He said, "Sorry, kid, I don't believe in fairy tales," and then he stabbed Will in the chest, killing him. And then Nancy, Kristen, and Kincaid all met up with each other. Then some door appeared, which led them to Joey. Yeah. And then Joey was just still had his arms and legs tied up, and he was just like right above a fire or something. Nancy told Freddy to let him go. Yeah, and then Freddy then started to release Joey from the being tongue-tied or whatever. And but before Joey fell in, Nancy was able to grab him to save him. Yeah. And, yeah, Kristen was trying to fight off Freddy while Kincaid also helped Nancy pull Joey out. Yeah. And then Kincaid started to go after Freddy. Then Freddy lifted him up and then... Yeah, Nancy then pierced Freddy's body, but yeah, it had no effect on Freddy. Freddy then ripped open his shirt and it showed a bunch of faces screaming on, like, his chest or whatever. Then Freddy then vanished, and then we got back to Dr. Gordon and Nancy's father at the junkyard digging. And, yeah, and then all of a sudden, Freddy's skeleton then popped up, started to fight Dr. Gordon and Nancy's father. And then... Yeah, as Nancy's father and Freddy's skeleton started to go at it, yeah, Freddy's skeleton then lifted up Nancy's father and threw him back, and yeah, some really sharp blade just pierced Nancy's father's body and killed him. And then Freddy's skeleton started to attack Dr. Gordon and then, like, put him in a where Freddy's body was buried or something, and he was starting to bury Dr. Gordon. Didn't bury him completely, yeah. Then Nancy, Kristen, Kincaid, and Joey were all like in some room filled with mirrors where Freddy was in every single one. And yeah. And then Freddy was pulling Nancy, Kristen, and Kincaid into the mirrors. And as they were all pulled in, Joey then shouted, "No!" And then all the mirrors just broke, and they were set free.
Yeah.
And, they all thought Freddy was gone. And then Nancy's father then appeared. Nancy went over there. And Nancy's father was apologizing to Nancy and saying that he loved her. And as they were hugging, turns out it was really Freddy. And then he stabbed Nancy in the chest, killing her. And then, then the door was shut and Kristen was left alone. And Freddy was trying to go after Kristen, but Nancy wasn't completely dead yet, trying to hold Freddy off. Then Dr. Gordon then recovered in the junkyard. And then he poured some of the holy water onto Freddy's body. And then you saw Freddy, he was like, started to like burn up or something. And then Dr. Gordon put a cross on the skeleton or whatever. And then you saw like a cross thing on Freddy's forehead. And then Freddy just disappeared. And then Kincaid and Joey opened the door, they were able to get in. And then Kristen was just bawling and cradling Nancy. And then then we saw Nancy's funeral. And then, Dr. Gordon saw Freddy's mother again, and he saw where she walked over to. So he went over there, and he saw the grave with Amanda Krueger on there. And that's when he figured out that she was Freddy's mother. Then, like at Dr. Gordon's house, while he was sleeping, there was the thing Kristen made of Nancy's house or whatever. And we saw, like, upstairs lights come on. And that's how the movie ended. So, yeah, like I said, 3.5 stars out of 4. Like I said, this is probably the second best Elm Street movie. Alright, so, that's all for my Nightmare on Elm Street 3 review. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys later.